Hi, Aries. Thank you for being here. I know how much I love and care about you. I do so appreciate all that you do and all the love that you all give me. I see you. Oh, I also want to give a big thank you to all those that have given me donations and that have booked with me. It has helped. It's made a big difference. I want to say a big dent. I know how much I care, know how much that means to me, and know how much I see you as well. I'm seeing the illustrations here. It's really standing out for me for your reading. This looks like compasses. I believe like that. Energy I'm moving through. Interesting. Let's see. Today's reading, we're going to look at, I was thinking about what's next in love or who's desiring you. I think I'm going to do who is desiring you. I actually like that one. Let's take a look here. We're going to look at, no, yeah. Let's look at who is desiring Aries right now. Who is desiring Aries? A beautiful energy to come through. We have the Golden Palace. I see this as, maybe this is someone well off, but the Golden Palace is that satiety, right? Is that where there is always enough. And there actually is. This is something that a lot of us struggle with because we constantly are seeing lack everywhere, right? Maybe you have lack programmed into you. Maybe your parents taught you lack, right? Maybe society has, but there's always, always, always enough. No matter what, there's always enough. And why do we know there's enough? Because there is, right? I do feel here, who's desiring you, someone who has enough, someone who is enough, and a connection where there is enough potential and enough compatibility, but not in like the bad enough. I mean like a good enough. Does that make sense? Yeah. I'll leave it just like that. So this is, I think that this deck may have I don't think it does have cornucopia. This is his cornucopia. So know that it is cornucopia. It's sexy stuff. I'm going to give you, because it kind of feels like something I would prefer, right? This person's amazing. I'll leave it like that. Hold on, I'll leave that. Hold on. We have Field of Dreams coming in there. For who's desiring. This is someone who daydreams about you with that Field of Dreams. You may feel their presence or their energy surrounding you. They have intentions for you. What intentions? Right now, their intention is to learn more about you and to figure out, I want to say, the inner workings of you. Maybe what you do for life or what you're interested in or who you are, yada, yada, yada. This person is all about that fantasy. I want to say that fantasy ship right now. With the intention, though, they are looking for, I think they want you. They are desiring you, but it feels like they do want that. I'm going to be honest with you. I can feel this. I can feel it a little bit. But right now, they're all about that fantasy. A really good example for this is a crush. someone who has a crush on you, someone who's very interested in that way. We have flying. They're looking at you from the highest perspective. I feel at first, learning more about you seemed daunting, or learning more about you seemed like it was going to be real difficult. Then they started to fly over that maze and they started to see things differently. They started to see you more clearly. You've sparked this person as well. It kind of feels like there's a strong, intense, like sexual attraction or a spiritual connection here that makes them, it lights them up or lights them on fire with that spark. The more they learn about you, the sparkier they get, right? With that strength coming through, it requires more and more strength to, I want to say, hold themselves back. I can see this a little bit, right? They are holding themselves back as they learn more about you. And then we have encouragement coming through as well. I feel recently or now-ish, right, this person is going to start to make their presence known to you a little bit more than they have in the past. And this is someone who has taken the time, this is the first card, to get to daydream about you, to fantasize about you, to learn more about you. And now they're going to start to feel, they are starting to feel like they're more... they have a better handle of the situation and they want to take action. With the home coming through... I feel like they want to take you home, Aries. I just did my pick a card. By the way, Aries, I do have a pick a card channel out. Anyway, we have Golden Palace. Not a coincidence. This person isn't looking for a hookup. They're not looking for something quick. They're not looking for something that doesn't last. They're looking for the thing that's going to last to the very end of their life. That's what they want. That's all they want. That's all that they're interested in. And so when they're looking at you through that. With that perspective, right? Can this work to the end, right? Are we compatible? Is there enough here? And that's what that Golden Palace is. There's always enough. It's a beautiful message. I think that should be part of a sorry, part of a mantra. I've been trying to come up with a real good one anyway. I digress. But it feels like this is someone who feels like you're, there's enough here. There's always enough. And it's there's beauty in that. With the strength coming through, and it's all the other is stuck in the mud. This person has been stuck on you, had a crush on you for quite a while. They learned enough about you, but they haven't really had the strength to take action towards you. This is going to change in the coming, I want to say coming days, weeks, maybe even months for others. With the Golden Palace coming through in that field of dreams, everything that they think of about you, that they know about you, that they've learned about you, makes them feel like it's you. You're the one that they've been looking for. And I know that we're asking who's desiring you. This feels way deeper than that. There feels like there's way more here than that. And I'm going to leave it just like that. Oh. Let's see. Let's get some tarot. So I want to know who is currently desiring. Like, who are they? Any nitty-gritty details? I can tell that this is a crush, someone who daydreams about you. But we get, like, I want to know who they are, like, on a deeper level. Don't you? Don't you want, like, who is this person? We have the Empress reversed. Interesting. I feel like they're a bit of a chaser. So this person is going to come after you. I'll leave it like that with that Empress reverse. With the Eight of Pentacles here as well, and it's reversed. Let's see. Let's get a few more. We have the Six of Wands. Like, who are they with the Ten of Cups? I felt this when I had the Empress. I feel like they have mama issues. I know it's crazy. I know we're getting that. But I swear, I feel like this person has mommy issues. And why do they have mommy issues? I don't know. But they have them, right? We have the Ten of Wands coming through as well. Interesting. With the Ten of Wands being the overall, this person has a lot of responsibilities. They have a lot on their plate. I feel like they could be established or definitely there's a potential for entrepreneur. Even like that. With that Empress in reverse, and the Three of Pentacles. This person will teach you a lot, and I feel like you're going to grow a lot together. Aries, it's funny. I had I spaced out a little bit, but who this person is they're a teacher, I feel. Professor, they definitely feel more established, and they have a lot to offer you and your connection. I feel like they may actually walk a different walk of life than you, and that is actually why they have so much to give you, and I want to say vice versa, because it's never just one-sided, is it? It's always two-sided, and I feel like this person is going to teach you a lot about life, a lot about their walk of life, and you're going to do the same. With the Six of Cups here, I feel like there is definitely a spiritual connection. This person likes to work on themselves, even though they may not appear that way. With the Six of Wands here, with the Ten of Cups as well, they've had a lot of success in their life, a lot. I feel like this person is financially well off, they're financially successful, they've made a name for themselves, and they've have almost everything but one thing. What are they missing? They're missing you. And this is where that Ten of Cups is reversed. It's interesting to come through. This person, I feel how you know them is they may dress well, but they feel like they're someone who has, they're established, they made a name for themselves, they know who they are, and they're just missing something, and it feels like they're missing the very thing that they're looking for. This person is going to, eventually they're going to put down this, I want to say this holding pattern that they're in, and make you an offer, make you that offer. It's going to be real good too. I'm going to leave it like this. I know it's like the craziest thing, and I just say this, I'll just loosely or lightly. I mean, you may ask this person about their dating life and think, and they may say they don't really have one or they haven't really had one. Don't think anything of that. They're ready, even if it feels like they may not be. I'm going to leave it just like that. They don't commit often to people, but they're really going to see something in you that makes this person, it opens up that door, opens up that thing. It's going to truly open something up. You're going to truly open up something in this person. They're going to realize they're missing something, and it's you. It's beautiful. I think like that. Let's get some more oracle. So can you tell me, where is this connection headed? Where is it headed for Aries and this person? Where is the connection headed right now? or sorry, the where will the connection be headed? I don't know if you talk to this person. You actually might, because I feel like they do know you, but they haven't made their move yet. They've been not biding their time. I don't see that. They just don't do this for anyone. They don't do this, I want to say, for anyone ever. And you are the one that's pushed this person to take this action that they want to take. And they may come in a little strong with that in Perseverance. No big deal, right? I feel like you're going to know that this person has a lot to offer and that you're compatible in ways that, I don't know. I'm just leaving like that, compatible, right? We have exceeding, yeah. This person is going, this connection is going to exceed expectations. You're going to be real shocked at that, by the way. Shocked at this person's and your compatibility. I feel like you're also going to be quite shocked at the fact that this person is going to give you a lot. When our lives are full, we have more to give people. And this person's life is pretty damn full. They're just missing something. I gotta be honest, it does feel like that. It's like they're missing, you know, when you need, I got a dog and two cats, and they're who I pour my love into, right? I have a lot of love to give, and I just give them that love. It feels like that. Like, this person has a lot to give, and they don't have, they have a lot to give, and they don't have anyone to give it to, and they want to give that to you. That's what you've sparked in this person, generosity. We also came out with cultivating prosperity. I do feel like there's a lot of prosperity in this connection. You're going to have really beautiful communication. You're going to feel very comfortable with this person as well. A golden palace type connection. This is something that is, this is significant for you and them. We have planting seeds and beautiful. I know that we, I remember when I first, when I was like, I don't know. You know, you always do this. You want to just have like a boyfriend or a girlfriend without the work. You're going to appreciate the work you do for this connection. And you're going to appreciate seeing it grow into something substantial. All right. And we have emerging into grace. I open my soul to grace. Beautiful. And Bob's going to be embracing the future. I do feel this is going to make both of your futures a lot better. It's going to make you... it's going to change your future and change your trajectory. With the emerging integration and exceeding expectations, I see a very strong soul bond connection. Someone you have a very strong soul connection with as well. I'm going to leave it just like that. Sorry, I balanced out real nicely. We have stepping into stillness coming through. It's an odd message, but I will say it. I feel like when you first meet this person, the world's going to freeze a little bit. Just a little bit. Not too much, but it feels like it's good. It's really going to... stop your heart. Sorry, I'm gonna leave it just like that. Stop your heart. Let's get some channel messages from this person that is desiring you. Can I have channel messages from this person for Aries? About this person desiring Aries again. This feels like a full-fledged, like this person desires an actual relationship with you. Let's see. We have I was meant for you, not a coincidence. There, I'll be honest with you. It feels like it was dialed. I feel like it was. Whatever. I feel like this is, it's basically what your reading's about. This is becoming, I'm not going to say problematic, but this person is having a hard time holding themselves back. They know that it's time to make their move. I feel like they actually will be soon. Anyway, they may come on just a little bit strong, right? I thought I had more time. This person did want more time to really think and reflect on this. It has to do more with, I feel it feels out of their comfort zone or out of their character. It does feel like that one. There could be something in their life they're holding on to, but they, when we get stuck in fantasies, right? When we get stuck daydreaming or reminiscing about what we desire rather than going after it, we can get stuck there, right? This person has got a little stuck with their fantasies of you. They need to break out of that, and they will. Let's see. We also have, do you even want me back? Some of you just could be a past person, but this does not feel that way to me. I guess it could be for some of you. We have, I thought the truth came after. I do feel here. This person doesn't want to release this, let you go, or not make a move towards you. They want to give it their best shot. And do you know when you... if you don't do something, you always look back and wonder what would have happened if I did it, right? You know what I'm talking about. This person wonders what would happen if they didn't try this, and they don't want to actually live that experience. They don't want to look back and wish they had made a move towards you, they're going to do it. They do see you clearly with that sun on the board, but I feel like you shine very brightly for this person. And we have, I'm not waiting a second longer again. And it came out with, I want to give you just as much as you give me. This person has a lot to give. And they're going to give you pretty much everything. I normally pull guidance, but I'll pull one. I'll pull one guidance for you. Anyway, this is a very intense connection that you have. Let's see one more time. Guidance for Aries. What is the guidance that you have for the Aries viewers? We have relationships and indecisions coming through with honesty. I feel like there could be connections in your life, Aries, that are meant to leave your life now. These could be people that are physically there, or fantasies that you have, or people that we hold on to, or things that we hold on to. Start to release all these things that are no longer for your highest good and are no longer for your highest potential. It's leading you to be a little indecisive. This person is an amazing suitor. And I feel like someone that you should be very open to, very, I want to say right away. But if you have things in your life that you're holding on to, you may reject them or you may not be as interested in them. Free up your life. This person is big, right? And they require... They would want you to be as free as possible. A good example for this is, let's say you have a group of friends, and you're always hanging out with them, and then you don't really have that much time for this person, or you don't have any room in your life for them. They don't want that. This is someone who's gonna want just as much, they're going to want just as much of you as they're giving to you, all right? The overall being honesty coming through as well. One thing that you're being guided to do, Aries, is really ask yourself what's more important in your life and for your life right now. Yeah. Anyway, I want to thank you, Aries. Don't forget to like and comment and take care. Bye.